Direct and inverse proportions. Identifying an inverse proportion and solving problems. Suppose we have 12 chocolates altogether. We want to distribute these 12 chocolates to some children. Here, the number of chocolates is fixed. What do you think? If we have 2 children, each one will get 6 chocolates. If we have 3 children, each one will get 4 chocolates. If we have 12 children, each one will get 1 chocolate. If we have 6 children, each one will get 2 chocolates. So when the number of children is increasing, the share of each child is decreasing. And when the number of children is decreasing, the share of each child is increasing. Both the quantities move in opposite directions. What did we just observe? If there are more children, the share of each child is less. If there are less children, the share of each child is more. That is why we can say the number of children and the share of each child are inversely proportional here. The share of each child varies inversely with the number of children. If for quantities A and B, when A increases, B decreases, and when A decreases, B increases, then we say that A and B are in inverse proportion. Quantities move in opposite directions. That is, A varies inversely as B. We write it as A is inversely proportional to 1 upon B. They are not equal but proportional. The equality can be brought as, we write it as A is equal to K upon B. This is called the equation of variation. AB is equal to K, where K is proportionality constant. Let us look at the examples of children and chocolates again. We have a total of 12 chocolates. When the number of children is 2, the chocolates to each child is 6. When the number of children is 3, the chocolates to each child is 4. When the number of children is 4, the chocolates to each child is 3. And when the number of children is 6, the chocolates to each child is 2. So when the number of children is increasing, the share of each child is decreasing. And when the number of children is decreasing, the share of each child is increasing. This is a case of inverse proportion. We write it as A is inversely proportional to 1 upon B. Or we write it as A is equal to K upon B. The equation of variation is AB is equal to K. Let us substitute values in the equation. Therefore, 2 into 6 is equal to K. Therefore, K is equal to 12. The constant of proportionality here is 12. The equation of variation is AB is equal to K. Therefore, A into B is equal to 12. Therefore, AB is equal to 12. Constant of proportionality K tells the amount of quantity that is fixed. P is inversely proportional to Q. When P is equal to 9 and Q is equal to 6, what is the constant of proportionality? And what is the equation of variation? If P is inversely proportional to Q, then P is equal to K upon Q. Therefore, P into Q is equal to K. Substitute values in equation. P is equal to 9 and Q is equal to 6. Then, 9 into 6 is equal to K. Therefore, K is equal to 54. This is the constant of proportionality. Equation of variation is P into Q, which is equal to K. Therefore, P into Q is equal to 54. A wall is built by some workers in certain number of days. Observe the table and fill in the blanks. As number of workers increases, number of days decreases. So, this is a case of inverse variation. The equation of variation is AB is equal to K. Let us substitute values from the first column in the equation. Therefore, 30 into 4 is equal to K. Therefore, 120 is equal to k. Constant of proportionality is 120. Therefore, the equation of variation is AB is equal to 120. So, the equation of variation is AB is equal to 120. Let us substitute values from the third column in the equation. Therefore, A into 8 is equal to 120. Therefore, A is equal to 120 divided by 8. Therefore, A is equal to 15. Put that value in the proper place. Let us substitute values from the fourth column in the equation. Therefore, 10 into B is equal to 120. Therefore, B is equal to 120 divided by 10. Therefore, B is equal to 12. Put that value in the proper place. Let us substitute values from the fifth column in the equation. Therefore, A into 24 is equal to 120. Therefore, A is equal to 120 divided by 24. Therefore, A is equal to 5. Put that value in the proper place. Our table is now complete. Let's take a look at another one. To pack a certain number of mangoes, 60 crates are needed. Each crate holds 36 mangoes. If a crate that holds 48 mangoes is used, how many crates will be needed? After reading the problem carefully, we know that the number of mangoes is fixed. In the question asked, the same number of mangoes are going to be packed in different ways. If more mangoes can be packed in each crate, would we need lesser crates or more crates to pack the mangoes? Obviously, we will need lesser crates. This is a problem of inverse proportion. Mangoes in each crate, 36. Number of crates, 60. If the mangoes in each crate are 48, what will be the number of crates? So, the equation of variation is AB is equal to K. Let us substitute values from the first column in the equation. Therefore, 36 into 60 is equal to K. Therefore, K is equal to 2160. So, the equation of variation is AB is equal to 2160. Let us substitute values from the second column in the equation. Therefore, 48 into B is equal to 2160. Therefore, B is equal to 2160 divided by 48. Therefore, B is equal to 45. We have calculated the answer. So, if a crate that holds 48 mangoes is used, we will be needing 45 crates. 45 crates will be needed to pack the mangoes. Let's take a look at another one. If a box of sweets is divided among 24 children, they will get 5 sweets each. How many would each get if the number of the children is reduced by 4? The number of sweets in the box is fixed. When the kids increase, the share of each will decrease and vice versa. So, this is a case of inverse proportion. The equation of variation is AB is equal to K. Let us substitute values from the first column in the equation. Therefore, 24 into 5 is equal to K. Therefore, 120 is equal to K. The equation of variation is AB is equal to 120. Let us substitute values from the second column in the equation. Therefore, 20 into B is equal to 120. Therefore, B is equal to 120 divided by 20. Therefore, B is equal to 6. We have calculated the answer. Each child will get 6 sweets. Let us look at another one. Two persons could fit new windows in a house in 3 days. 1. One of the persons fell ill before the work started. How long would the job take now? 2. How many persons would be needed to fit the windows in 1 day? The total effort required to fit the windows is fixed. When the number of workers increase, the time needed will decrease and vice versa. So, This is a case of inverse proportion. Let's put the given information in the tabular form. When the number of workers is 2, days needed to finish work is 3. When the number of workers is 1, we need to find the days needed to finish the work. And we need to find the number of workers needed to finish the work in 1 day. The equation of variation is AB is equal to K. Let us substitute values from the first column in the equation. Therefore, 2 into 3 is equal to K. Therefore, 6 is equal to K. The equation of variation is AB is equal to 6. One worker out of 2 is not working, so only 1 is. Therefore, 1 into B is equal to 6. Therefore, B is equal to 6 divided by 1. Therefore, B is equal to 6. Therefore, 6 days will be needed to finish work for one worker. Now, we have only 1 day to finish work. Let us substitute values from the third column in the equation. Therefore, A into 1 is equal to 6. Therefore, A is equal to 6 divided by 1. Therefore, A is equal to 6. 6 people will be needed to finish the work in 1 day. Did you understand the concept of inverse proportion? Yes? Very good!
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.